Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we are going to look at another creative way to practice your scales, be it major or minor, and also look at a very important technique which you need to practice on the piano. And hopefully this gives you a different perspective, a lot more creative options, and will take your playing forward to the next level, right? And this is part of a three-part series. So if you haven't already, do head over and watch part number one, where we talk about expanding and compressing the hand, you know, which gives you a lot of creative options, and it's a very important technique. In this video, we are going to look at crossing over. Okay, crossing over is a very important thing for the piano player because our keyboard is just one line of notes, right? Unlike a guitar where you have six strings, and what happens when you run out of data, you just skip to the next string, isn't it? Because the guitar is tuned in fourths, or in one instance in thirds. So whenever you run out of fingers, you just use the next string and the fingers just go down. On piano, how do we do that? We can't. You don't have another piano to latch on to. That may actually be an interesting idea. But anyway, we have left with this. So crossing over is very important. The first thing you need to practice when you cross over will be to move like this. Okay? Just get used to this motion. So if I just keep my hand here on the piano, use your thumb and your wrist. So your thumb sort of goes under the fingers, and then you push the rest of your hand to go this way, and when you come down, the other fingers go over the thumb and it comes down this way. This is how you descend and this is how you ascend. Sort of like a moonwalk of your fingers, if you will, right? So this is ascending, and when you do all this fancy stuff, make sure you don't move your elbow at all. You don't need to move your elbow, doesn't help at all, okay? So it may look like I'm moving my elbow, but actually I'm not. I'm just moving my forearm. Here you go. This is what's happening. I'm sweeping the piano. The elbow is close to the body. In fact, it's touching my stomach. Right, there we go. That's how you go. Okay, so the exercise basically grows this way and this way. So if this is your E, we're taking E major scale, as well as maybe E minor. Sometimes we forget to do minor in an exercise. We just keep doing major, you know. So we'll just do both. So the exercise is basically what I call as the pendulum exercise, which allows your hand to move this way as well as this way, what we call as the positive y-axis and the negative y-axis. So let me show you what's going on and then I'll explain. So what is happening here? My thumb is on the root, in this case E of the E major scale, and my index finger plays F sharp, which is one step up. Then you come back to the root and play D sharp. So E, F sharp, E, D sharp. And even though you can use other fingers, I would recommend that you just practice with your index itself. Index going to F sharp, index going back down to D sharp. E, F sharp, E, D sharp, like a pendulum, right? F sharp, E, D sharp, E, F sharp, E, D sharp, E. Speed that up if you'd like. Sa re sa ni, sa re sa ni, E, F sharp, E, D sharp, E. That's one up, one down motion. Then you could also do two up, two down motion. How will two up, two down motion work? That's E, F sharp, G sharp, coming down to D sharp, C sharp, D sharp, E, repeat. One, two, three, and four, and sa re ga re sa ni. Now when you descend, you can cross your middle finger, which is nice. Then index slips there. But then your thumb gets a bit sort of cluttered and this muscle starts hurting a bit, right? So you go, take the thumb away and bring it back. Another thing which students do would be index, thumb, index, and then bring back the thumb. That could also work well. So practice both perhaps. D sharp with your middle. Or with your index, and then the thumb needs to produce the additional C sharp. But it's still in the pendulum motion. Right? So one up, one down. Two up, two down. Pendulum continues. Basically, how much is it going to go till you run out of fingers? In this case, my pinky is the last finger. So the next objective could be three up, three down. That's ma, a. Sa re ga ma, a. Na re sa. Now when you cross over, I feel it's annoying to cross this ring finger. So cross your middle finger instead. D sharp. C sharp, B, C sharp, D sharp, E. You bring back the thumb because you don't have enough fingers. So you have to come back the thumb and then bring back the thumb to the root. But the motion is still pendulum. Come back to the root, and it's also important to know that it's creating like a triplet feel or a 6x8 feel. 1 2 3 4 5 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6, right? So it's good to keep that in mind because you're counting in sixes rather than maybe in fours, if you will. So you go 1 2 3 1 2 3 1, cross over the middle finger. Index, thumb, index, middle, back to unity, back to root. Okay, so that's three up, three down. Last but not least, we have the four up, four down. Now with four up, four down, you may be tempted to cross the ring finger, because then it brings back your thumb. But again, if you want to avoid the ring finger, which I feel is a little annoying, you could cross the middle. On the way down, middle, index, thumb, there's a little more crossing going on here, back, up. Let me show you that again in slow motion. Pa ma pa ma ga re sa, middle, ni dha pa, index, pa, thumb, back to index, middle, thumb. So 4 up, 4 down again. You can look at it as 16th notes. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a 1. Then 1 up, 1 down. Look at it as 8th notes or 16th notes. 2 up, 2 down. It's just when you do 3 up, 3 down, we look at it more as triplets. Na 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 na, takita, one triplet, two triplet, one. Now with the pendulum, now that you've accomplished, you know, one up, one down, two up, two down, three up, three down, and four up, four down, well, the first thing you could do is try the same procedure out on the minor scale of the same key. So E minor. In this case, E harmonic minor with that D sharp. So and every scale is going to pose new challenges, but it's pretty much going to align like this. Your thumb will anchor and then everything floats this way of the thumb and the other side of the thumb. And why I think this is very important when you're, you know, a newcomer to the instrument especially, or even someone like me who's been playing for a while, is because it trains your ear and your mind to react to data this way as well as this way. When we practice our scales like this, we are training our mind only going positive axis above the root or the sa. We are kind of programming ourselves to believe that there may not be anything below the sa, right? So what if the scale started on the root, it can even go below the root, it can go above, it can go octaves skipping. So there's so many things which can happen, right? So that's basically the pendulum exercise. And if you can, at the end of exploring the major as well as the minor versions of the pendulum, you can start jumbling things up, you know, and defy the laws of physics, if you will, with the pendulum. You can maybe consider going two up and one down, or maybe one up and two down. So if I do two up, one down, two up, one. So, sa re ga re sa ni, right? Ga re sa ni, sa re ga re. Change the rhythm. Or maybe one up, two down. So, you get the idea, right? You can then do three up, two down, three up, one down, and see what it can yield, right? And this is where the pendulum exercise, I hope, will actually allow you to be creative, improvise, and create a song, create a melody of your own while doing it. Right, guys? So this was the pendulum exercise to explore scales, both creatively as well as technically, I hope. The creative aspect is to travel both parts of the y-axis, which is very important, around the root. And the technical aspect is to practice crossing over the thumb, which is very, very important for any piano player, because our instrument is linear. It's just one line, just one string, if you will. There are no, you can't skip and play the next segment, right? So moving on to part three, we are going to cap this series off with the third very, very important approach towards practicing scales, both creatively as well as technically. I will see you in part three. Till then, if you haven't already, subscribe, turn on the bell, leave us a comment if you'd like to learn something else, and keep rocking. Cheers.